think it's because Absalom, when he went over there, then sent the king to Amasa, assemble me, the men of Judah, within 3 days, and be thou here present. So Amasa went to assemble the men of Judah, but he tarried longer than the set time which he had appointed him. And David said to Abishai, said to Amasa, "Art thou in health, my brother?" And Joab took Amasa by the beard with the right hand to kiss him. But Amasa took no heed to the sword that was in Joab's hand. So he smote him therewith in the fifth rib, and shed out his bowels to the ground, and struck him not again, and he died. So Joab and Abishai, his brother, pursued. Joab's men stood by him and said, "He that favoreth Joab, and he that is for David, let him go after Joab." And Amasa wallowed in blood in the midst of the highway. And when the men saw that all the people stood still, he removed Amasa out of the highway into the field, and cast a cloth upon him, which he saw that everyone that came by him stood still. He was removed out of the highway. All the people went on after Joab to pursue after Sheba, the son of Bichri. And he went through all the tribes of Israel and to Abel and to Beth Maacah and all the Beerites. And they were gathered together and went also after him. And they came and besieged him in Abel of Beth Maacah. Cast up a bank against the city, and it stood in the trench. And all the people that were with Joab battered the wall to throw it down. Then cried a wise woman out of the city, "Hear, hear, say, I pray you, unto Joab, come near hither, that I may speak with thee." And when he was come near unto her, the woman said, "Art thou Joab?" And he said, and he answered, "I am he." Then she said unto him, "Hear the words of thine handmaid." And he answered, "I do hear." Then she spake, saying, "They were wont to speak in old times, saying, they shall surely ask counsel at Abel." And so they ended the matter. "I am one of them that are peaceable and faithful in Israel. Thou seekest to destroy a city and a mother in Israel. Why wilt thou swallow up the inheritance of the Lord?" And Joab answered and said, far be it from me that I should swallow up or destroy. The matter is not so, but a man of Mount Ephraim, Sheba, the son of Bichri by name, hath lifted up his hand against the king, even against David.
Oh, wow.
Then the woman went years of famine in the days of David, 3 years, year after year, and David inquired of the Lord. And the Lord answered, it is for Saul and for his bloody house, because he slew the Gibeonites. And the king called the Gibeonites and said unto them, said unto the Gibeonites, what shall I do for you, and wherewith shall I make the atonement, that ye may bless the inheritance of the Lord? And the Gibeonites said unto him, we will have no silver, nor gold of Saul, nor of his house, neither for us shalt thou kill any man in Israel. And he said, what ye shall say, that will I do for you. And he answered the king, the man that consumed us and then devised against us that we should be destroyed from remaining in any of the coasts of Israel. Let 7 men of his sons be delivered unto us, and we will hang them up unto the Lord in Gibeah of Saul, whom the Lord did choose. And the king said, I will give them. But the king spared Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, because of the Lord's oath that was between them, between David and Jonathan, the son of Saul. But the king took the 2 sons of Rizpah, the daughter of Aiah, whom she bare unto Saul, Armoni and Mephibosheth, and the 5 sons of Michal, the daughter of Saul, whom she brought up for Adriel, the son of Barzillai, the Mehelethite. And he delivered them into the hands of the Gibeonites, and they hanged them in the hill before the Lord. And they fell all 7 together, and were put to death in the days of harvest, in the first days, in the beginning of the barley harvest. So is that March or April? That's when the new year begins, right? You kind of have to see what they're saying there. So it's the beginning of the year. In Rizpah, the daughter of Aiah took sackcloth and spread it for her upon the rock from the beginning of harvest until water dropped upon them out of heaven. It suffered neither the birds in the air to rest on them by day, nor the beasts of the field by night. And it was told David what Rizpah, the daughter of Aiah, the concubine of Saul, and David went and took the bones of Saul and the bones of Jonathan his son from the men of Jabesh Gilead, which had stolen them from the street of Beth Shan, where the Philistines had hanged them. When the Philistines had slain Saul and Gilboa, and he brought up from thence the bones of Saul and the bones of Jonathan his son, and he gathered the bones of them that were hanged, and the bones of Saul and Jonathan his son buried they in the country of Benjamin in Zalah, in the sepulchre of Gish his father. And they performed all that the king commanded, and after that God was entreated for the land. Moreover, the Philistines had yet war again with Israel, and David went down and his servants with him and fought against the Philistines, and David waxed. And Ishbi-benob, which was of the sons of the giant, the weight of whose spear weighed 300 shekels of brass in weight, he being girded with
here.
So these giants have probably been after him his whole life after what he did to Goliath.
I never heard of this guy. Ishbi Benob. Probably Goliath's friend. Mm-hmm. Yep, that's what's going on. Something. Avenging Goliath. They don't say it. Let's keep going.
But Abishai, the son of Zerua, suffered him and smote the Philistine and killed him. That's good. His friend Abishai. His war buddy. Yeah, they're still after him. That's weird. Then the men of David swear unto him, saying, "Thou shalt go no more out with us to battle, that thou quench not the light of Israel." And it came to pass after this that there was again a battle with the Philistines at Gob. Then Sebechai, the Hushathite, slew Saph, which was of the sons of the giant. But they're just all over the place.
So we heard about Goliath, right? Now here's two more. There's this guy. Ishbi Benob, and there's another giant called Saph. And they killed him. Abishai.
And there was again a battle in Gob with the Philistines.
Look how they even call it Gob instead of I know they're not calling it God, but we do now. But what a weird name, right? Remember that candy?
Gobstoppers.
Okay. See? I never even read this. See? It's totally heading in that direction. Look how the Holy Spirit. So, Elhanan, the son of Jaar Oregim, a Bethlehemite, slew the brother of Goliath, the Gittite. So there's three more. They've been hanging around all these years, at least. There's thousands, probably.
The staff of whose spear was like a weaver's beam. And there was yet a battle in Gath. That's where Goliath is from.
There's like a lot of them over there. Oh no, here we go again.
Where was a man of great stature that had on every hand 6 fingers and on every foot 6 toes, 24 in number? And he also was born to the giant. And when he defied Israel, Jonathan, the son of Shemaiah, the brother of David, slew him.
There's just like three in a row. There are four.
These four were born to the giant in Gath and fell by the hand of David and by the hand of his servants. Yeah, they just were after him for killing his brother, for killing Goliath this whole time. So, I never knew that. There's four more. There's Ishbi Benob. There's Saph.